Sean Connery, and trust me, that ain't left to Martin, but I am here on a very special assignment of my own. You see, about 20 miles that way is an historic piece of infrastructure that served the people of this region well for nearly 100 years without any problems at all. That is, until now. Just down there is the Spitalamb Dam, one of two man-made walls that were built a long time ago to form this enormous body of water known as Lake Brimsel. Why does any of that matter? Well, it may not be as famous as the dam it looks exactly like in America, but this structure does have its own place in history.
You see, Spitalamb is one of the world's first large arch-gravity dams. It was built up here in the mountains between 1925 and 1932, and is actually older than the iconic Hoover Dam that we all know and love, which completed 3 years later. At 114 metres, Spitalamb was also one of the tallest dams in the world when it finished. The vast structure was built by some 600 construction workers, almost entirely by hand. It's where a dam curves upstream and narrows, using its own weight as support bracings to force most of the pressure of the water behind it against the rock walls of the canyon that it sits in. They're ideal for when you're in an area of particularly hard rock, just like this part of the Alps, and they require less material than similar methods.
The completion of this incredible structure meant that a new artificial lake could be created, and that's now used to generate hydroelectric power. Now, this lake is absolutely massive. It has a volume of 94 million cubic meters, making one of the biggest reservoirs owned and operated by energy company KWO, and one of the biggest reservoirs in the whole of Switzerland. But about 30 years after this amazing structure was completed, a pretty shocking discovery was made.
In the 60s, when the area was becoming popular with both tourists and filmmakers, some tests were made on the dam which threw up some very worrying results. Investigators found a big old crack on the lakeside of the structure. Well, actually, it was more than a crack. It's what's called a vertical separation. In other words, a massive chunk of material running almost all the way from top to bottom has started to separate from the rest of the dam, the mass concrete. There's a smaller horizontal crack below the crest of the dam as well. Over the years, it's been getting worse, and there are concerns about what might happen to the structure in the event of an earthquake.
Yes, Switzerland does get those. In fact, it averages more than 1,000 a year. Most of them are too small to even notice. In fact, there could be one happening right now for all I know. But the one that occurred back in 1991, for example, was big enough to cause damage to buildings. Now, at this point, I know what you're thinking. Why go through all that effort building a great big new dam in front of the original dam? Why not just repair the original dam or fix that crack somehow?
Well, that was the original plan. Break off the material that's already separating and patch it up with some new, better quality concrete so that it's even stronger than before. But it turned out to be too risky. An investigation showed that doing that could lead to a so-called alkali aggregate reaction, which could cause long-term damage to the concrete. On top of all this, quite literally, sediment has started building up behind the dam and is now accumulating around the lower discharge zone. That's not good, because if this area gets completely blocked, it'll become harder to release water from the reservoir if they need to.
The worst case is that in 30, 40 years, when the perform will not größer geworden sind, the fall not größer. We have a großes Erdbeben here, then could it be that a Teil der Mauer in the See fällt with a Flutwelle here, that die das Tal behind bringt.
So, what if they just removed the dam? Well, that would mean all of that water having to go somewhere else. And because it's used to generate hydroelectric power, that would leave a gap in the energy grid. That left them with only one option. Build an entirely new dam in front of the old dam, and then flood the massive space between them using a tunnel. The original dam I'm currently standing on is going to be retained. It's a piece of history after all. But the job of carrying the weight of all that water is going to be taken over by the new, younger and fitter dam. Now, when I say it like that, it sounds really simple. But trust me, it's not.
It's going to take a lot of time and money. Luckily, the country's home to more than 800,000 millionaires, and that's on a population of only 9 million people. Millionaires who've had to adapt recently. The country's leading financial institution since 1856 collapsed earlier this year. In fact, Bloomberg reports families worth over half a billion, Swiss or otherwise, are changing their strategies, looking to other safe haven investments, with another area of interest being collectibles, with the greatest allocations to art. In fact, thousands of the B1M subscribers are employing a similar strategy with our sponsor, Masterworks' art investing platform. Masterworks has racked up impressive returns for sold works and has acquired over 300 paintings. While a single return is not a guarantee of future returns, their 15th exit, a Cecily Brown piece, was just a few days ago for a 77.3% annualised net return. Masterworks now has $800 million in assets under management, and the B1M subscribers can skip their waitlist at the link in the description.
Now, let's get back to the damn video.
I've been to a lot of construction sites, but never seen anything like this. Cost-wise, the $140 million new dam is pretty small compared to your typical mega project, but its sheer scale and the challenges facing its teams are immense.
Right here is where it's being built, with the old dam towering behind it. Construction has been underway since 2019 and is due to fully wrap up by 2025. Now, obviously, a lot's changed in dam design since the 1930s. The original dam was built with a single arch, which is that huge curve you can clearly see from here. But take a look at the cross section, and the left side of the dam rises in a straight line.
Now, its replacement is going to be a double curvature dam, which means it will curve in a vertical direction too. That means the dam's walls can be made thinner and need less materials, while still having the strength needed to hold back all that water. The new dam will be the same height as the old dam, but strong enough to be further extended in future if there were ever plans to grow the reservoir. Building all of that goes like this. It started with clearing space for the new dam. Now, this being solid rock, the team used controlled explosives. And doing that right next to the old dam that's holding back a massive lake full of water without damaging it is just about one of the trickiest construction maneuvers ever pulled off. From there, the vast dam wall is rising as a series of staggered 15 meter wide towers over the course of 4 summers. It's built like that so that each segment can dry or cure faster, and to increase the overall strength of the dam wall.
Das schwierigste an diesem Projekt ist die Sicherheit der alten Mauer. Wir arbeiten direkt vor einem vollen See und müssen jederzeit sicher sein, dass der alten Mauer wirklich nichts passiert. Also auch bei den Sprengarbeiten zum Beispiel, bei allen Tätigkeiten, die wir machen, muss die Mauer sicher sein.
Overall, some 215,000 cubes of concrete will be used. Next, a huge tunnel is being carved through the mountain. That will allow water to be discharged from the reservoir and sent downstream if the levels ever get too high. But before the excavation can be completed, the reservoir must be completely drained by sending all of that water down into the hydro power system. Teams will then clear the sediment on the lake bed and dig the rest of the tunnel before allowing the reservoir to refill naturally. After that, they'll gradually flood the area between the two structures, and a new dam will take over the task of holding back the weight of the lake.